Hello, hello, I'm Li Hao. Today we are going to talk about one big important feature in Svelte. And it's one of those powerful things that sets Svelte apart with everyone else, which is the Reactive Declarations or Statements. Well, so what is Reactive Declarations and Statements? We shall see. But let's start with this example first. So over here, I've created a component that has a count variable initialized with 1. And I have two buttons, which has decrement and increment. So whenever I click, I will increment or decrement the value of count. And at the same time, I have these expressions called counts times 2. Anything within a curly brackets can be a JavaScript expression. So over here, I'm gonna say counts times 2 over here so I can see this is always 2 times of the count. So this is okay, right? Nothing's wrong with this. But what if I have another button over here and I'm gonna call it do something because I'm not sure what I'm gonna do yet. I'm gonna say click me. Okay. And in this function, I'm going to define this. Okay, now I know what I'm going to do. I want to console out the value 2 times of count. So I probably have to come over here and say count times 2 again. And so that every time when I click, I see the value 2 times of count is printed in the console. So nothing's wrong with this. Because this example is simple. But what if you have a more complicated example where you have a super complex formula over here and you want to access this variable at a lot of places? Well, at that point of time, you probably would realize that you can't calculate this on the fly anymore and you would want to come here and define this variable called double. So initialize with counts times 2. So I'm going to show double over here. And then I can use this as well. But as soon as you do this, you realize that, so at first it's 2 is correct, but if you increment, it's still 2 because you got to update this variable double. So you come over here and look at all the places that you do counts plus plus that you all count minus minus, anywhere that you make changes to counts, you have to say updates the value of double as well. And this does not scale. It works, but this does not scale because what if you have another button? I'm going to call e scale because it does not scale. All right. Okay, I'm going to say multiply. Alright, so I come over here, I have a function called multiply. And what it does is that counts equals counts times count. Always multiply by itself. So now again, I need, this is out of sync again, because I need to come over here and do double equals counts times 2. I need to remember to do that every time I add a way to update count. So this is error prone. Every time you update counts, you need to remember to update double. And this does not scale. So what should we do? Well, this is where reactive declarations comes in. So this statement itself. So a declaration is a type of statement, and this statement itself is a declaration statement. Because over here we actually declare this variable double. So reactive declaration is a declaration statement that instead of you call let double equal something, you start with a label dollar. So this dollar label over here, you use a dollar label over here and you write double equals counts times 2. Right, so you replace the good old declaration and with this reactive declaration. So what is this dollar label thing? Well, this is actually a label statements used usually with loops or for loops, while loops, where you can label a loop and then you can break it, right? If you have a multiple nested loops and you want to break the loop at the second level, right? You normally break can only break the nearest level, but you want to break like some first level, second level, or third level of loops, then you have to label them and then you break with the label. So this is actually a label. And if you know that this is a label, which means that actually I need to define this variable double, right? But then you don't have to. You don't have to come over here and let's double, right? In normal JavaScript, you would have to do this, but in Svelte, what we do is that we call this reactive declarations and we will inject the let's double for you. So you don't have to declare it, right? You don't have to define it. So you write this, and then there's this magic of reactive declarations. What it does is that it will always execute every time when you change count. So which means I can save my time not to do this. My code is cleaner as well. I don't have to come over here and manage the double whenever I change count. And you can see this double value changes instantly when I change count. So this is reactive declaration. So let's talk a bit more on this reactive declaration. So you've seen like why we need this, because every time when you change a variable, you have to manually, painstakingly update a new value that derives from this, right? So you see the why, but let's talk about like how it works in more detail. So over here, the title, I say reactive declarations and statements. So this is not just declarations. This can be any statements. So any statements that start with a dollar colon will be a reactive statement. So I can come over here and say console log count. This is again a reactive statement. So reactive statement, reactive declarations. The only difference is that declaration is to declare something. And if you declare something, means that you don't have to define let's double yourself. Right, it's being declared together with this statement. And sometimes, of course, if you write this, it is still okay, right? You can still define it, but the point is you can omit it if you want to. So these two, okay, reactive declarations and reactive statements. And how does they work? How do they work? How they works is that actually, they will actually look at what I call a dependency of the statement. So what dependency means is that if something, so these statements, these reactive declarations or statements depends on something. And what is that something? That something is variables, states variables that is being used within this statement itself. Okay, so what are they? So for declarations, it will always be all the variables on the right of the equal sign, right? You depends on these variables to update the value of double, right? So anytime when you see assignments in a reactive statements or declarations, the one on the right are the dependencies. So this double depends on count, right? Two is not a variable. So for statements, you don't have assignments, then any variables that you can see here are the dependencies, right? So if I say count, so over here, this example will have two. The console, you depends on console and depends on count. Over here, you depends on count. So I prepared some more examples over here. Let's see them. So full name, first name, last name. So this is a declaration. So or assignment, so whatever on the right, which is the first name, on the last name is the dependent. So anytime first name or last name change, this whole thing will be evaluated. But here for this case will be A, B, and C. Anytime A or B or C changes, this whole statement will be evaluated. But here is num1, num2, and calculate, because it's still an assignment. And over here, this is a statement, so whatever is a count. Actually, this is the same example, so I'm going to remove this. Right. Copy this down over here. Right. Over here, do something, A and B. So anytime any of these changes, you will have to reevaluate these statements, right? So when we reevaluate, say in our previous example, we reevaluate meaning we have reevaluate this, which means that we're gonna reassign the new value to the variable double. So why this is important? Well, this is important because if, say for example, if you have do something, A and B, but you do something with, say, console log A, B, and C. You do something with A and B and C, then you have to know that anytime C changes, you will not call this function at all, because it only depends on here, right? So if you define this, only do something A and B, A or B, or do something changes, will call this function again. But anything that is being used over here, C is from outside, like if you have counts out from here, or you come up with a new variable D over here, whenever that, okay, this can't change, right? But any variables that you refer from this function, outside of this function, changes, this will not call, meaning it will not call this function, right? So that is one thing that you need to take note of. So second thing that you need to take note of is that when this is being evaluated, right? When this is being called is important, because when this is being evaluated decides when this the value of the double being updated. So if you come over here and I say console log double, I'm just gonna add this so that you know that it's double. When you come over here and you run this and I click increment, you'll see that this value always lags behind of what it shows. In fact, this is actually the previous value that you see, right? If I click scale, you see that this, now it's 18. When I click, it shows 18. This is the previous value. You haven't update double, right? You tell me that whenever you change, you will update this value of double. Yes, but not immediately. It's not immediately. It's asynchronous. It's asynchronous. It does not happen immediately, but it happens right before Svelte update the DOM. Right before it updates this double over here, it evaluates this. Okay, it gets a new value of double. Now it's 20, and then it shows on the screen. But over here, it's not there yet. So when you come over here, you change counts, see that the value of double is still the old value. So this is important because Svelte can't go all everywhere else whenever you change count and then increment the double immediately. There's a lot of work. So it only happens right before the Svelte updates the DOM. So this note number two that you need to take note of. Then the third thing that I want to talk about is the order of the reactive statements, right? So I can come over here. I can come over here and then do something like console log double. So let's practice what this statement depends on. Depends on console, depends on double, right? So anytime console or double changes, this statement will be reevaluated. So you expect that double, so over here, every time double changes, you evaluate this. Right, so you expect this will show the latest value of double. Well, in fact, it does, right? So now it's 4. You reevaluate this right before it updates the DOM. Okay, double is now 4, and then you console log 4. But what happens if you write this right before when you evaluate double? Well, if you write it right before, Svelte actually will reorder it for you. So what it means is that Svelte actually will look through all the reactive statements and reorder them based on the dependency order. So in this case, double depends on counts, right? This statement says double depends on counts. This statement says it depends on double, right? Nothing, it does not create anything, but it depends on double. And if I come over here and have another variable, say quadruple, equals to double times two. So this quadruple depends on double. So you would expect that you can't see quadruple. Okay, let me show it here, quadruple. Right, so yes, quadruple is written before the double equals to counts times two, but the dependency has order itself. So you have to reorder Svelte. Not you have to, but Svelte will reorder this for you. Will say, okay, doubles depends on count, so this, but then quadruple depends on double, so this has to come after. Right, and then this console depends on double, so this has to come after. So if you have cases like this, you have cases where two things are depends on double, then the initial ordering does matter, right? The order does matter. It's just that if there's dependency order, then that counts in priority, higher priority than your initial ordering. So for example, if I come over here, console log double two equals to double, right? These two statements, both these two statements depends on double, but the initial order does matter. So if you write double two first, then you see double two and double. But if you reorder this, reshuffle, come over here, you'll see double first before double two, right? The order does matter, but the dependency order counts first. So that is notes number three. The dependency, the order of the order of your reactive statement will be reordered based on the dependency order. So hopefully these three notes, the dependency order, and then they will be evaluated asynchronously. These three things, if you remember it carefully, you can avoid a lot of pitfalls involved with reactive statements or declarations. Lastly, a few other things that probably you also need to take note of is that reactive declarations or statements only happens at the top level, so only here. If you come over here and define something like this, double equals counts plus two or something, it has no effect outside of the top level. It already shows you this warning, right? So yeah, that is something else, a small thing that you need to take note of. Whoops. So that's all for reactive declarations and statements. So if you have anything that you want to add on, or you have questions, any doubts, comments down below. As always, give me a thumbs up if you like this video. I appreciate it a lot, because that makes me happy and make more videos, right? And remember to subscribe to my channel so that you get notified when the next one is out. So see ya, bye bye.